The Columbus Blue Jackets are on the verge of facing every sports team's favorite problem, a problem where they have too many good players that cannot all start at once. That case being here, the Elvis Merzlikins and Joonas Korpisalo situation. Korpisalo is getting closer and closer to returning. Merzlikins has been lights out since he's been down, and it's been a beautiful thing for the Blue Jackets here these past couple months. Merzlikins currently sitting at 10-6-4 on the season with a 9.25 save percentage at 2.42 goals against. He finds himself sitting at 10-2 since taking over the reins back there at net when Korpisalo went down. But you take a look at Korpisalo, don't forget about that lights out December. He had such a great month that he went out there and actually had the All-Star game nomination prior to the injury. Currently sitting at 17-10-4 on his season with a 9.13 save and a 2.49 goals against average. Now getting the 9.13 doesn't look as sparkly as the Merzlikins one, but keep in mind Korpisalo, these Blue Jackets, they did start the season a little bit slow, and we brought it up, he was just absolute fire in the month of December. And it brings up the big question: when Korpisalo returns, what do you do with these goaltenders? The one thing I'm always afraid to do in a goaltender situation is most goalies play great when they, you know, they have a chance to get into a rhythm, they're playing consistently. And if you bring Korpisalo back and you split time with these guys, they don't get that chance to consistently play. They're playing, you know, night in, night off, night in, night off type of deal. And I've never been a fan of that. Goalies typically, when he can get in that groove, they play really well. Merzlikins, Korpisalo are great examples here. You know, Korpisalo wasn't the hottest back there playing backup last season. Merzlikins this season didn't pick up any wins until he finally was given the reins there after Korpisalo went down. Both of them, you know, they struggle in the limited time, but you said, here you go, here's your chance to prove yourself, play your best hockey, we're going to throw you out there every single night. They find that rhythm and they start playing to their full potential and looking really good out there. So it really scares me to go out there and say these guys should split starts, but it really feels like that might have to be the case here. The thing with Merzlikins and Korpisalo that's different than a lot of situations a lot of goal or teams come up with when it comes to goaltending situations where it's like, what should we do, should we split starts between this guy and this guy, is a lot of the times you'll see teams, one of the goalies will be young and the other one will be the old season veteran. You're like, well, we want the young guy to be the future, we want to work him in more, it's not a big deal type of thing, we want him to play more, we'll give him the keys to the castle right now, we're happy to do that because he's going to be our future. But the Blue Jackets situation is they're sitting on two goalies that sit in that situation. You know, you don't want to close the book on Korpisalo or Merzlikins. Both of these guys have the potential to be future studs for this team, for this franchise, and the last thing you want to do is go out there and say, you know what, Korpisalo is playing great, it was his starting role in the first place, he's coming back, we're going to give him all the starts again. And you bury Merzlikins, and then you know you risk the chance of not seeing him prosper. So you almost, it feels like one of those cases, you know, same could be said about Korpisalo not playing when he comes back, but it feels like one of those cases where rarely will you hear me say this, that they should go out there and split the time and let the two duke it out. I don't really have another resolution right now looking at the way they're playing back there in net. I don't know, maybe somebody, what are you guys' thoughts on that? You got a different idea now, Merzlikins and Korpisalo, that's a tough one, that's a very tough situation. Like I said, you know, it's 30-25 or 35 and, you know, it's such an easier thing to look at and say, worry about the guy in the future. But the last thing you want to do is kill one of these guys' confidence by not playing them a lot. Or, you know, at the same time, though, you look at the flip side and say, well, they both split time. Now they're not going to get in that rhythm. The good thing with the Blue Jackets is here, I think you look at the end of the season, they play 9 games in 16 days or something at the end of the season to close out the season. So I feel like if there is some bouncing back and forth between these two goalies, the end of the season, both of them will get a lot of reps in a, you know, a limited amount of time. As bad as it sounds for the rest of the team not getting the rest, it's good for the goalies, both of them getting a lot of reps in a short or short period of time. Maybe then, you know, you see the one that comes out in front there if the Blue Jackets are fortunate enough to make a playoff run here, and then that's the hot hand you go with in playoffs. But I think you almost have to let them duke it out and go with the hot hand from there.